When the president delivers his State of the Union address in just a couple hours from now, a transgender soldier will be sitting in that audience. Congressman Joe Kennedy, Democrat, Massachusetts, invited Staff Sergeant Patricia King to be his guest in the wake of the president's attempts to keep transgender troops out of the military. The sergeant has served in the Army for almost 19 years, but now her military future is in doubt. And I had a chance to speak to her before she left for Washington. I have read that you have described your life lately as, quote, hanging in the balance. Can you tell me what you mean?
Well, when the announcement was made that they may decide to go back to banning transgender service, for so many transgender service members, myself included, that raised questions about what's going to happen to me. Am I going to be fired or let go? Will I have the opportunity to continue to serve my country? And for others who are looking to enlist into the military or commission into the military, will they have that opportunity?
Tell me why you want to attend the State of the Union. What message are you hoping to send just by your sheer presence in that chamber?
The State of the Union is an important part of our political process that demands accountability of all of our elected officials. I look forward to the opportunity to attend, just to be a part of that process and to be one of those faces in the crowd, one of those people that demands accountability from the government. We all have a say when we have the opportunity to vote, and this is our chance to hold accountable those people that we elect into office.
Let me just play for you a little bit of what we've heard from Republican leadership, what they had to say when President Trump first announced the transgender military ban by tweet. Listen.
The concern here in the House was whether or not the military will be forced to pay for these surgical procedures. I share those concerns.
Based on consultation that he's had with his national security team, came to the conclusion that it erodes military readiness and unit cohesion, and made the decision based on that.
It's been a very difficult situation, and I think I'm doing a lot of people a favor by coming out and just saying it. As you know, it's been a very complicated issue for the military. It's been a very confusing issue for the military, and I think I'm doing the military a great favor.
You say you are the first member of the military who's received gender reassignment surgery actually paid for by the military. What do you say to those critics, including the president himself, who tweeted about the tremendous medical cost and disruption you could cause?
What I would say is that retaining the best and brightest has a cost to it, whether it be providing maternity leave or a medical procedure or sending them to a school so that they can be better trained. That's just part of doing business when you take care of your service members. As far as the cost of this, that's been looked at over and over again. It's been refuted at this point. I think we've all determined that the cost is not actually an issue. It's very negligible. As it applies to my surgical procedures, I actually went out of my way. I found a surgeon who was willing to waive their fee in the midst of all that this has been going on. So Dr. Christine McGinn did the surgery at no cost to me, and she incurred all of those costs. The military paid only for the operating room and anesthesia fees.
Well, my heart goes out to you and all of the brave servicemen and women who serve and protect this country. Thank you so much, and we'll see you at the State of the Union.
Absolutely, see you there.